Hi, my name's Dimitri, and I review productivity apps. Why did I do an intro this time? So in this one, we're going to talk about Wrike.com, which is a project management application that can be used for teams, sort of for personal use. I wouldn't really recommend it for it's a business thing. From a pricing perspective, you get free for up to 5 people, I believe, and it's pretty much task management. Then professionally, you get project planning and team collaboration. Business, which is the most popular, you get a customized platform for any team or use case. And the pricing on this guy is $25 a month, but it's really advanced. So $9 a month looks good, but when you compare the two of these, you get custom workflows, project blueprints, a whole branded workspace, automation engines. So it can be more than one solution in the sense that it can get rid of other timesheet applications or time tracking application prices that you may want to factor in there. And it even has a Salesforce integration, which is always nice. The free version has web, desktop, and mobile apps, personalized app experience, task and subtask management, external and internal collaborators, and interactive board and spreadsheet views. Getting into just the basics of this, you'll see that there is a bunch of different options for different views, similar to that of things like Notion and whatnot. You have a list view, a board view, table, Gantt, and then if we press the plus sign here, you can see there is actually resources, stream, time log, and analytics. So a Gantt chart is obviously something that works really well for time management, for project management for companies, and it's not something I use often, but some nice things you can do in here is you can highlight overdue tasks. So for example, say we move this here, highlight overdue tasks, so it'll change that to red. Highlight critical path as well, and you have the option to hide empty folders. So these guys are empty, so it would hide those. You have the option to collapse all, expand all, and this is essentially different folders that contain the different project stuff here. So as you can see right here, you can toggle these open and on as well. And then from the table perspective, very similar how there's a bunch of different sub projects within them. So if I add a new item, this is an example, sample task, and then under it, you can make this a subtask by moving it in and hiding it. By moving it onto that, and then it'll make it the subtest. So if we click on this, it'll show up all of the different things here. You can add dependencies, have approval, so set new approval, so you need somebody to approve of said thing before you move forward with it. Add an assignee, add dependencies, which are I think are really great, things that you need to do before and after tasks in order for them to get done. You can share it with others, and then you can change the status here from new or in progress, completed, on hold, canceled. And then just like that in the list view, you're also able to go in and see what different tasks there are per person and then the different folders within this view like that. And then from a board perspective, it'll change it based off of the progress or the default workflow sort of status over there. And you can easily move things between that. And then as you can see, clear filters to see it. So what just happened was is that this is filtered to where it's only newer in progress. So you can change all that so you can see more by doing that. You can also add different filters, like have it so that there's some parts of the approvals or certain assignees, different levels of importance, completed date, or you can even add a custom field here as well. And as you can see here, you can even add a custom field to the right here for something like created date, author of the task, ID of the task, completed date, importance. There's effort here, as you can see, you can change that. Time spent, this is the duration, which would be the time spent. And you can sort things in here just as well by due date, status, importance, title. And then from a tools perspective, after we went through the projects and folders, we can add dashboards, calendars, reports, and workload charts. So if I had a dashboard here, to example, RP dashboard, you'll see that I can create a new set of widgets here. So if I do like a project widget, include projects from subfolders, add this to the dashboard. Then I can do a task by status widget. I can choose specific projects. So let's do new tasks. Or you can do my pending reviews. It'd be like, what do I need to review? So let's put an example task on here. Add assignee, Dimitri, approvals, start new approval, add approvers, Dimitri. And then also another option here is to do something like my backlog, see a list of all tasks without dates that are assigned to you and have an active status. An activity stream, so we can see just all the different things in this activity stream. Then outside of dashboards, you're also able to make things like calendars. You can see timesheets here. Different custom reports can be made within here, so active tasks by assignee. And then you select the project data source. So if I go YouTube, it would show that some of them are assigned to me, some of them are assigned to none. And for companies in general, showing your workload chart is really convenient so that you can see how everyone's workflow is, how much hours they're spending on their different work, so that they don't get overwhelmed with the quantity that they have. And then going to the top right here, you can add apps and integrations. And there is a litany of different options here. So there's Salesforce, which is obviously one of the best ones, QuickBooks, which I'm sure works well with the timesheets, Marketo, Zoom for meetings, Slack for chat, and then there's actually things like Google Drive, which I say is always really convenient for a project management app. Same thing with OneDrive or SharePoint. Wrike for Microsoft Teams is great, Gmail. So while the pricing on this app may be a little bit high and it looks a little bit old from a UI perspective, the functionality is completely there. I can't deny that this is one of the better functionality project management apps on the market. However, I don't like the look too much, but if you're a company that doesn't really care about that and you want just something that works, I would not go against recommending this. This is a very good option, but I would recommend you also check out this video on how to improve your productivity even more.